Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's take a look at quick actions in Spotlight. So a big new productivity feature in macOS Tahoe is the ability to launch quick actions using Spotlight. One way to do this is to click on the Spotlight icon in the menu bar, and then you could just start typing the quick action here. Or you can click on the third button on the right, and you can see that will take you directly to actions, showing you just the actions here and limiting your search to just actions. You could also do the same thing with Command Space to bring up Spotlight search, and then Command 3 to go to actions, or just simply Command Space and then 3. Then you'll get this long list of actions broken up mostly by app. Let's take a look at 10 examples of how these could be useful. Let's start off with setting a timer. There's an action down here, if you scroll down to the clock area, for start timer. Now, you don't have to scroll down here and click on this. You could just start typing that. So start timer, and you could see when it's the first item at the top, the one that's selected, at that point, you could just press return, and now you've entered the quick action. Most quick actions will ask you for some parameters, in this case, a duration number and minutes. Usually you don't need to move your fingers off your keyboard to use these. For instance, for this one, I can just type, say, 5, and then at that point, I can press return, start a timer for 5 minutes. I can also tab to the second parameter here, and it shows me a list of options. I could start typing one, or I could use the down arrow to select one of these options here. Let's just select minutes and press return, and now you can see the complete command. Another return will launch it. And you can see here at the top, it shows that a timer has been started. And now if I go into the clock app and look at timers, you could see there's my timer. It simply added a timer to the clock app without ever launching the clock app. And there are plenty of other quick actions that involve the clock app, like for instance, setting an alarm. Instead of setting it here in the clock app, I could just do set alarm. And notice here, I didn't go to the action section. I just used the default catch all for Spotlight, just command space, and then I searched for set alarm. It's the second option here. And I arrow down to it, press return, and that would create an alarm for time, say 5 o'clock, and I can name it something like this, and then add the alarm. And you can see how it added the alarm there in the clock app. Also note that once you've used a quick action, like start timer, notice that you might see some characters here on the right. These are quick keys, and they originally were just blank, but the first time you use quick action, we'll assign some quick keys, in this case ST, to it. You could also click here to assign your own. You can simply delete them, or you can change them. Once you've got some quick keys set there and you notice that, you no longer need to type a part of the name. You could just use those exact characters. So here in Spotlight, I'll use ST, and you can see that's going to be the first item that appears here. And I can press return and get right to it. Now let's jump right to a really interesting one. You could actually manipulate files using Spotlight. And you could do this by first selecting what you want in the Finder. So for instance, I want to move this file right here into this folder. And in this example, it would be easy just to drag and drop. But let's say that this second location isn't somewhere that's visible here in this window. It's in a very different place. Now, I could use Spotlight with that file selected, and I could use the move file action. And you could see it's right here. I'm going to press return, and it'll allow me to use the current selection there. It'll even show me down here what the current selection is so I can confirm it's got the right thing. So if I were to simply tab over to the next item there, it asks for a folder. This is a search field. I could search and it will come up with a list of results for folders. And in this case, this is the one I want. So I could select that and I could see the full command there, and you could see that it ran and actually moved this file from here to here. If I didn't have a file selected, I can use move file, and you can see NF has been assigned here. So let's just use NF and then return, and now I can search for the file. So I could search for city here, and I could find the right one and then search for the folder and move it like that. So I don't even have to have the files or folders visible at all to do the move. And one similar to that is delete file. So with three files selected here, I can look for delete files, and you can see it says current selection, three files. And if I were to press return, it would move those three files to the trash. Now you saw with start timer and set alarm, it didn't even need to launch the clock app to set those. And you could do the same with other apps. So for instance, I can send a message and then I could type the message and who it's to like that. If there are several here, I can select the one I want and it'll actually send the message. You could see a little indicator that it's been done right there. It never launched the Messages app. So it's a quick way to send messages, and you can also use it to send email. You can type a message and then a subject and then one or more recipients, and it'll send the email without ever even launching the Mail app. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MacMost through Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. You can also use the Maps app without launching the Maps app. So one of the things you can do is type get travel time. And then you have a bunch of parameters. Like for instance, you can change driving to walking. And then you could set current location or from some other location. And then it'll run and it'll get you a travel time. Just simple hours and minutes. But if you do want to get actual directions, then you can use open directions like this. Search for a destination and simply press return. I will launch the Maps app and show you those directions. You can also create a new calendar event without launching calendar. So look for the quick action new event, and then you add a title and a start and end time, something like this will do, and then press return. And then by going to calendar and I look, I'll see the event right here. Now you may be wondering if there's an action to search for an event in the calendar. And there's not an action for that because that's a search. And that's primarily what Spotlight does. So you can just use a Spotlight search for that. The way to do it is to start typing the name of the app. So like calendar. Now, if I were to press return, it would assume that I want to launch the calendar app. But in fact, what I want to do is search for information in the calendar. So instead of return, I'm going to press the tab key. And now you can see how the calendar app there at the top becomes this kind of search parameter. And you could still type after it. So if I were to type dentist, then you can see it comes up with a list of events found in the calendar that match that. Now, of course, you can do the same things you do for calendar for reminders as well. So do new reminder like this, and then you can add a new reminder to, and then you get to choose the list here if you have multiple lists, and then return, and it will add it to reminders. And just like with calendar events, you can use the name of the app and then tab to search for a reminder. You can also easily add to an existing note or create a new one. So in Spotlight, look for append to note, run that, and then type whatever the text is like that, tab over to note, and you'll see a list of your notes. You can start typing or select the one you want. Probably your most recent note is going to be at the top there. So it'll be pretty easy. You run it, and it'll run. You'll see the little indicator there at the top. Always look for that. And now if I look in my notes, you could see it added that line. You can also create a new note really easily with create note. And then it's going to ask for contents. Remember, the first line of a note is going to be the title. So this will end up being the title of the new note. You can go over here to a folder and you've got various folders that you've created there. I'll add it here. And you can see it's created that note. And then I can add to the note by using append to note and type something and then the note like that. And you can see I created the note and I started adding lines to it. Now, not all these actions work as well as they should. Now there is an action for convert image. So I'm going to look for that and there it is. Now I'm going to press return and notice it has current selection there as the first parameter, and it even shows me underneath what it thinks is the current selection. So that's correct. I'm going to tap to the next parameter here, and you can see everything I can convert it to. I'm going to use JPEG, and I'm going to press return. And what do I get as a result? Well, I get to view a JPEG version of that file. It doesn't actually save a copy next to the real one. But it does actually save the copy. If you control click, right click, or two finger click on this, you could open the new version it created, copy it to the clipboard, and you could also show it in the Finder. And if I do that, it's going to show me it put it in the downloads folder and called it attachment.jpg. So it did do the conversion. It just put it in a weird place. Now, likewise, there's also a quick action for resize. It works the same way. I can use the current selection and I could run it and I will get a resized image like that. And I could show in Finder, you can see it's still going to save it to the downloads folder. Now you can also do some text manipulation with Spotlight. So one thing you can do is replace text. Then you could type what you want to replace and with what, and then the text to look in like that. And then you get the result and you can control click on it and copy the result. Now you can actually use this in text that you've selected. So I'm going to select all this text here in an email message and I'm going to command space and then replace text. And then notice it says selected text. Well, I don't want that to be the first parameter, but that's okay. I'll just type Fox. I'll go to the next parameter and you can see it moves selected text to the next thing. So I'll type there and then tab and it moves selected text over yet again. That's where I want it to be. I'll press return. And now I've got the new text here. I can control click on it, copy, and then I could paste it in here if I want. And while this works in some apps that have been updated since macOS Tahoe came out, it doesn't work yet in others. So for instance here, it won't work in Pages. You can see it just doesn't get the selected text. You can also use an action to get quickly to markup tools. So you can select, say, a PDF or an image here, and then command space, and then just say markup. And you can see it looks for the current selection, or you type the name of the file to search for it, and it will go right into Quick Look in markup mode for whatever that file is. And here's a bonus one. You can run a shell script right from Spotlight. So you don't need Terminal for a quick single command. I'll look for run shell script and I will run this and it asks me for the script to run. So I can type something like network quality to test the network. This actually takes about a minute to run in Terminal. So it's going to take a minute to run here as well. And you can see here are the results of this. And now that I've used it once, it's going to be a lot easier because it has assigned a set of quick keys, RSS, and you could change that to whatever you want. So I could type RSS and then return and then just type or paste in a command like this one will show me the top four processes running on my Mac. And one last tip I want to show you is that if you've got quick keys set up for one of these, like RSS, you could just do space and then put in the parameter that's there if it's a single parameter like this. So I never had to press tab or select the item. I could just run this and it's going to assume that what comes after the quick keys is the parameter. And remember, there are a lot more of these. In Spotlight, use command 3 to go to actions here and scroll through this really long list. Try these out and experiment with them and see which ones could be useful to you.